साहिब जी तो सुनानाथ अनाथ नमो सर तो सुनादानी नमो सो पिखारी मो सुनादीन दयाल न तो सर मो सो अज्ञान न तो सो बिचारी मो सो न पतित न पावन तो सर मो सो बिकारी न तो सो उपकारी मेरे है अव गुण तू गुण सागर जात रसातल ओट तिहारी मेरे है अब गुण तू गुण सागर जात रसातल ओट तिहारी सतगुर आयो शरण तुहारी मिले सुख नाम हर शोभा चिंता लाहे हमारी अवर न सूजै दूजी ठाहर हार पर्यो तो द्वारी लेखा छोड़ अलेखै छूटै हम निर्गुण ले हो उबारी सद बख्संद सदा मेहरवाना सबना दे अधारी नानक दास संत पाछे परियो राख ले हो एहो बारी तन तन गुरु ग्रंथ साहिब जी महाराज दी हाजरी विच जुड़ी हुई बैठी हुई सात संगत जी आओ गज गज के फतेह आखो जी वाहिगुरु जी का खालसा वाहिगुरु जी की फतेह सो महाराज की कृपा दे नाल सात संगत जी अज असी कीर्तन सोहिला रखिया ने शब्द के पाठ की कथा शुरू आरंभ करनी हैगी है सो इट विल टेक क्वाइट अ फ्यू वीक्स टू गो थ्रू एवरी सिंगल शब्द एंड द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इट So, Maharaj Kirpa Kare, as we start this part, Guru Sahib bless us all. Because this part is very important. Every Sikh should read this at night time. I'll go into why in a little while. But Sasanga Ji, just obviously I've been away for a couple of weeks. So, I just want to tell you guys, ki ho riya sega. Because I said before we're going to India. So, we had our very first Sikhi camp in India. This wasn't, hon aam toor te jo asi camp karde hain. ਇਹ ਸਿਰਫ ਅਸੀਂ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕਿਸੇ ਹੋਰ ਦਾ ਕੈਂਪ ਆ ਆਪਾਂ ਸੇ ਜਾ ਕਥਾ ਕਰਨੀ ਹੈ ਪਰ ਇਹ ਸਾਡਾ ਪਹਿਲਾ ਕੈਂਪ ਸੀਗਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਕਿ ਬੇਸਿਕ ਸਿੱਖੀ ਨੇ ਆਪ ਕੀਤਾ ਸੋ ਇਟ ਵਾਜ਼ ਕੁਆਇਟ ਅ ਬਿਗ ਅਚੀਵਮੈਂਟ ਫੋਰ ਅਸ ਐਂਡ ਐਸਪੈਸ਼ਲੀ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਇਟ ਵਾਜ਼ਨਟ ਈਵਨ ਇਨ ਇੰਗਲੈਂਡ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਮੇਨ ਸੇਵਾਦਾਰ ਇੱਥੇ ਹੀ ਹੈਗੇ ਨੇ ਇਟ ਵਾਜ਼ ਇਨ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਵਿੱਚ ਬਹੁਤ ਘੱਟ ਕੈਂਪ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਅਸਲ ਵਿੱਚ ਦ ਵੇ ਦੈਟ ਦੇ ਹੈਪਨ ਅਬਰੋਡ ਆਲ ਓਵਰ ਦ ਵਰਲਡ ਇਜ਼ ਵੈਰੀ ਫਿਊ ਲਾਈਕ ਦੈਟ ਇਨ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਸੋ We thought, well, UK's already got three. Hana? There's Boss Camp, there's Seek to Inspire Camp, there's Khalsa Camp. So maybe we should do one in India. And the Sangat was asking for that as well. So Maharaj Kirpa was a great success. I don't know if you can see the photos up there. I did ask the Singh to put the projector on, but I think we had the whole campsite. It was in the countryside. Fridabad de bilkul lage si, Haryana vich. Hon gal e si ki pura camp takriban Punjabi vich hi siga. ਹੈ ਨਾ ਅਤੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਪਤਾ ਲੱਗ ਗਿਆ ਉੱਥੇ ਪਹੁੰਚ ਕੇ ਕਿ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਨੌਜਵਾਨ ਦਿੱਲੀ ਦੇ ਹੈਗੇ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਬੇਨਤੀ ਕਰਦੇ ਕਿ ਭਾਈ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਥੋੜ੍ਹੀ ਅੰਗਰੇਜ਼ੀ ਬੋਲ ਦਿਆ ਕਰੋ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਪੰਜਾਬੀ ਪੱਲੇ ਵੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਪੈਂਦੀ ਸੋ ਇਟਸ ਅ ਸੈਡ ਸਟੇਟ ਆਫ ਅਫੇਅਰਸ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਗਰੂ ਅਪ ਇਨ ਚੰਡੀਗੜ੍ਹ ਇਨ ਦਿੱਲੀ ਔਰ ਸਮਟਾਈਮਸ ਨਾਓ ਈਵਨ ਇਨ ਲੁਧਿਆਣਾ ਐਂਡ ਜਲੰਧਰ ਐਂਡ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਫਰੋਮ ਲਾਈਕ ਐਜੂਕੇਟਡ ਫੈਮਿਲੀ You don't understand Punjabi so much. Because ghar vich vi Hindi chaldi hai, te school vich vi Hindi ya Angrezi chaldi hai. So our language, our Pasha, is being lost. If you read Anand Sahib, it's literally in Punjabi. If you read Sukhmani Sada part, it's also in Punjabi. If you read Chandi Diwar, it's also in Punjabi. So ejere part hai gane Maharaj ne likhe ne, they all in Saral Punjabi. And the people of Punjab now, the Punjabi people in India are starting to lose Punjabi. Asi ta khair waqai bahut dur hain. Itthe to samajh sakde ho. Itthe koi naujawan kahe mainu nahi samajhandi. But you can accept somebody here saying, "Bhai sahab, I don't understand Punjabi. English is gal kar lo." But in India, I was a bit surprised. So, but they don't know why. Again, they don't know why they should learn Punjabi. The asal gal itthe aa jandi hai. कि सिखा नूं पता नहीं कि पंजाबी जरूरी क्यों है क्योंकि सिखा नूं अजकल सिखी भी जरूरी नहीं लगती सिख नौजवान डोंट थिंक दैट सिखी इज इंपोर्टेंट एज वेल टुडे बिकॉज़ इट्स बीन साइडलाइंड इन टर्म्स ऑफ इंपोर्टेंस एजुकेशन इज मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंट जॉब मनी हाउस एंड देन समवेयर डाउन द बॉटम कम सिखी एंड इन द ओल्ड डेज व्हाट वाज द सेइंग सिर जावे ता जावे मेरा सिक्की से देख ना जावे back in those days we said you know what पावे मेरा बच्चा पढ़े ना पावे मेरा बच्चे चंगा काम भी ना करे बस सिक्की ना छड़े now it's like चलो जे चंगा काम कराना है पढ़ाई करनी है तो चलो सिक्की छड़ देने की होंदा so all the Christian schools are succeeding because of the same very thing they offer very good education but every day you walk under the statue of Mother Mary And उत्थे तो ने सिखाया जाना है वो Christianity is, and they teach you nothing about Sikhi. And the Sikh schools also, unfortunately, some of the Sikh schools don't even teach you Sikhi either. It becomes more of a job to get you to learn a few things. So this camp, when we started the camp, we did a das to Maharaj. Maharaj said, "Kirpa karo, Maharaj, hukum na baksho ki is camp te aisi kehdi gal karni hai." So Guru Sahib ne hukum na baksha. कि जिसके सिर ऊपर तू स्वामी सो दुख कैसा पावे बोल ना जाने माया मदमाता मरना चीत ना आवे मेरे राम राय तू संता का संत तेरे तेरे सेवको पौ किछ नाही जम नहीं आवे नेरे Maharaj says, don't be scared. Darna nahi, do part. He'll be with you all the time. But then they say, Jo tere rang rate swami, tinka janam maran dukh na sa, teri baks na mete koi, satgur ka dilasa. Naam te ayan, sukh phal payan, aat pahar arad hai. तेरी सरन तेरे परवास है पंच दुष्ट ले साध है and then the most beautiful thing Maharaj says ज्ञान ध्यान किछ कर्म ना जाना सार ना जाना तेरी सब ते वड्डा सतगुर नानक जिन कल राखी मेरी Satsang ji, Shabad, this akhri do pangtiya na. We come there, we think we know so much. Maharaj says, Kuch fikr ka, don't worry about what you know. You don't know anything, but one thing you need to have. Maharaj says, even if you have gyan, tyan, kich karam na jana, sa na jana teri, I don't know how to value you. I don't even know how amazing you are. Maharaj says, but I know one thing, I have sharda in my heart. The people all over India, paave Punjabi, jere Punjabi parivar to hai na, paave Punjabi andi ni na, But they have one sharda in their heart. They know ki sab te vadda satguru nanak. Jin kal rakhi meri. The greatest of the greatest is Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, who is in Kaljug protecting me. So we made the whole camp about sharda. We made it all about belief in Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj. Because nowadays people of even Sikh heritage with dariya, kirpana, paga are now questioning this very pankti and saying ki nahin. ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਵਿਸਰਾਮ ਹੈ ਗਲਤ ਹੈ ਦੇ ਸੇਇੰਗ ਨੋ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਕਹੋ ਸਭ ਤੇ ਵੱਡਾ ਸਤਿਗੁਰ ਉੱਥੇ ਰੁਕ ਜਾਓ ਡੋਂਟ ਸੇ ਨਾਨਕ ਇਸੇ ਨਾਨਕ ਜਿਨ ਕਲ ਰਾਖੀ ਮੇਰੀ ਦੇ ਸਿੰਘ ਦੈ ਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਥੋਕਿਨ ਬਾ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਨੋ ਅਬਾ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਐਜ਼ ਇਫ ਬਾਈ ਪ੍ਰੇਜ਼ਿੰਗ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਯੂ ਟੇਕਿੰਗ ਅਵੇ ਫਰੋਮ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਹਾਓ ਇਜ਼ ਇਟ ਪੋਸੀਬਲ ਦੈਟ ਵਾ ਪ੍ਰੇਜ਼ਿੰਗ ਅ ਪੇਂਟਿੰਗ ਯੂ ਟੇਕ ਅਵੇ ਫਰੋਮ ਦ ਪੇਂਟਰ ਜਿਹਨੇ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਬਣਾਇਆ ਤਨ ਤਨ ਰਾਮਦਾਸ ਗੁਰ ਜਿਨ ਸਿਰਿਆ ਤਿਨੇ ਸਵਾਰਿਆ ਹੂ ਮੇਡ ਯੂ ਗੁਰੂ ਰਾਮਦਾਸ ਜੀ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਦ ਵਨ ਹੂ ਮੇਡ ਯੂ ਜਿਨ ਸਿਰਿਆ ਤਿਨੇ ਸਵਾਰਿਆ ਹੀ ਇਜ਼ ਮੇਡ ਯੂ ਬਿਊਟੀਫੁਲ Our Guru was made by Vaheguru. He was sent with the complete light of Vaheguru. Sent to go in here with a mission. He was made by him, made beautiful by Vaheguru. Those who saw Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, na, they fell in love with Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj. They wanted to stay in his Sharan all the time. And now people are putting question upon this very Pankti. So we made it all about Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj and how great they were. And those people that came in the beginning of the camp, that were worried about singing Panktiyan like, ਤਨ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਤੂੰ ਹੀ ਨਿਰੰਕਾਰ ਇੱਕ ਤੂੰ ਹੀ ਨਿਰੰਕਾਰ ਐਂਡ ਦੇ ਸੇ ਓ ਇਹ ਕੱਚੀ ਬਾਣੀ ਹੈ ਵੀ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਦੈਟ ਥਿੰਗ ਇਨ ਦੇਅਰ ਇਜ਼ ਓ ਕਿ ਕੱਚੀ ਬਾਣੀ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਕੀ ਹੈ ਵੀ ਠੋਕਟ ਬਾੜੇ ਹੈ ਵੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਅਨੰਦ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਦੀ ਕਥਾ ਪਰ ਕੱਚੀ ਬਾਣੀ ਉਹ ਨਹੀਂ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਕੋਈ ਸਿੱਖ ਆਪਣੀ ਸ਼ਰਧਾ ਨਾਲ ਕੋਈ ਆਪਣੇ ਭਾਵਨਾ ਨਾਲ ਕੁਛ ਲਿਖ ਦੇਵੇ ਦੈਟਸ ਨੋਟ ਕੱਚੀ ਬਾਣੀ ਕੱਚੀ ਬਾਣੀ ਇਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਬਾਣੀ ਵਿਚ ਇਜ਼ ਰੈਡ ਵਿਦਆਊਟ ਧਿਆਨ ਅਪੋਨ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਵੈਨ ਯੂ ਰੀਡਿੰਗ ਯੋਰ ਪਾਠ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਫੋਕਸਿੰਗ ਅਪੋਨ ਦ ਗੁਰੂ ਦੈਨ ਇਜ਼ ਕੱਚੀ It's not pakki. It's not fully realized like a mango. You can eat it when it's kacha. You can have a banana when it's kacha. It's not yet ripe, but you can eat it. But Firibi, it's not perfect. In the same way, when we do our part, but we're not focusing upon the guru, then that bani becomes kachi. Because the shabad about kachi bani, Maharaj says, Satguru bina, hor kachi hai bani. Bani ta kachi. Satguru bajo, hor kachi bani. Kehende, ਕੱਚੇ ਸੁਣਦੇ ਕੱਚੇ ਕੱਚੀ ਆਖ ਵਖਾਣੀ ਤੇ ਸਪੀਕਿੰਗ ਕੱਚੇ ਤੇ ਲਿਸਨਿੰਗ ਕੱਚੇ ਵਾਟਸ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਰੋਂਗ ਹਰ ਹਰ ਨਿਤ ਕਰੇ ਰਸਨਾ ਕਹਿਆ ਕਛੂ ਨਾ ਜਾਣੀ ਯੋਰ ਟੰਗ ਇਜ਼ ਮੂਵਿੰਗ ਬਟ ਯੂ ਨੋਟ ਐਕਚੁਲੀ ਫੋਕਸਿੰਗ ਅਪੋਨ ਇਟ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਸੇਜ਼ ਚਿੱਤ ਜਿਨ ਕਾ ਹਿਰ ਲਿਆ ਮਾਇਆ ਦੋਜ਼ ਹੂਸ ਚਿੱਤ ਹੈਜ਼ ਬੀਨ ਸਟੋਲਨ ਬਾਏ ਮਾਇਆ ਚਿੱਤ ਜਿਨ ਕਾ ਹਿਰ ਲਿਆ ਮਾਇਆ ਬੋਲਣ ਪਏ ਰਵਾਨੀ ਰਵਾਨੀ ਮੀਨਸ ਆਟੋਮੈਟਿਕਲੀ Those whose consciousness, their concentration has been stolen by Maya and they're speaking automatically, jive bani kant ho jandi na, and it comes out without you concentrating. Maharaj says, that's what's happening here. O kachi bani rahegi. So this question is for those people that read their bani without concentrating and Maharaj is saying, O kachi rah jandi hai. Dhyan naal padhya karo. Imagine Guru Sahib being in front of you. And then the camp was all about Sharda. Those people have started off by saying, Nahi, e kachi bani, I'm not going to sing this. By the end of the camp, they were singing it as well. Why? Because Guru Granth Sahib Ji says, Gur Samrat, Gur Nirankar, Gur Ucha Agam Apar, Gur Ki Mehma Agam Hai, Kya Kathe Kathanhar. Gurbani is saying, Gur Samrat, Gur Nirankar. Guru is Nirankar. Aap Narayan Kalatar, Jagmeh Parvaryo, Nirankar Akar Jot, Jagmandal Karyo. That Nirankar who couldn't be seen has come upon earth as Guruji. So, by praising Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, you don't take away from Vaheguru. Jin Nanak Satguru Pujaya, Tin Har Pooj Karava. By praising Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, Satguru Nanak, God causes you to be exalted. That's what Bani is saying. Thought to kuch karta nahi, Vaheguru doesn't get unhappy with you if you start praising Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj. Vaheguru in fact causes other people to come and say well done and shabashi to you if you praise Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj. It's ult. So, Maharaj Ji Kirpa, the camp went really well. Sangat badi pasand hoi sigi. They were very happy. Te appa bhi bade khush hoye. Really enjoyed the camp. Maharaj Ji Kirpa, we're going to try and do another one this year in South India. Utthe thoda kat honda ya. You know, Madras, Bangalore, Chennai, those places. Mumbai, those places. So you're going to do one in the south, one in the north. So Satsang Ji, apna pichhe apna wapas pahunchi hai apne vishay te, Kirtan Sohila da paath. So we're going to start now by imagining ourselves in early 1500s. Bhai Lehna Ji has become a Sikh of Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj. Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj has travelled for so many years and now they've come back to Kartarpur Sahib. ਕਰਤਾਰਪੁਰ ਵਸਾਇਆ। ਸੰਗਤ ਦੇ ਸਿੰਘ ਦੇ ਸਰਵਿੰਗ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਵਨ ਪੁਆਇੰਟ ਦੇ ਵਾਜ਼ ਅਬਾਊਟ 20,000 ਪੀਪਲ ਲਿਵਿੰਗ ਇਨ ਕਰਤਾਰਪੁਰ ਦ ਵਨ ਦੈਟ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਜੀ ਮੇਡ। ਸੋ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਨਾਓ ਅ ਸੈਂਟਰ ਫੋਰ ਸਿੱਖੀ। ਭਾਈ ਲਹਿਣਾ ਜੀ ਇਜ਼ ਡੂਇੰਗ ਅਤ ਸੇਵਾ ਆਫ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ। ਦ ਹੋਲ ਟਾਊਨ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਇਮੈਜਿਨ ਦ ਮਾਹੌਲ ਆਫ ਕਰਤਾਰਪੁਰ, ਸਵੇਰੇ ਸ਼ਾਮ ਕੀਰਤਨ, ਸਵੇਰੇ ਸ਼ਾਮ ਸੰਗਤ। ਕੈਨ ਯੂ ਇਮੈਜਿਨ ਹਾਊ ਬਿਊਟੀਫੁਲ ਇਟ ਵੁੱਡ ਹੈਵ ਬੀਨ ਦੈਟ ਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਵਾਜ਼ ਦੇਅਰ ਰਾਈਟ ਦੈਨ ਐਂਡ ਦ ਹੋਲ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਵਾਜ਼ ਅ ਸਿੱਖ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਬਿਕਮਿੰਗ ਸਟਰੋਂਗਰ ਐਂਡ ਸਟਰੋਂਗਰ ਐਂਡ ਸਟਰੋਂਗਰ। ਐਂਡ ਇਨ ਦਿਸ ਸਿਚੁਏਸ਼ਨ ਇਟਸ ਆਫਟਰਨੂਨ ਬਿਟਵੀਨ 3 and 6 ਐਂਡ ਗੁਰੂ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਇਜ਼ ਰੈਸਟਿੰਗ। ਐਂਡ ਵਾਈਲ ਦੇ ਰੈਸਟਿੰਗ ਇਜ਼ ਸਲੀਪਿੰਗ, ਸਮਬਡੀ ਇਜ਼ ਹੈਵਿੰਗ ਅ ਰੀਅਲੀ ਸਮਬਡੀ ਇਜ਼ ਬੀਇੰਗ ਇਜ਼ ਵੈਰੀ ਲੱਕੀ, ਵੈਰੀ ਬਲੈਸਡ ਟੂ ਡੂ ਸੇਵਾ ਆਫ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਐਂਡ ਮਸਾਜਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਫੀਟ। ਗੁਰ ਕੇ ਚਰਨ ਉੱਪਰ ਮੇਰੇ ਮਾਥੇ, ਬਾਣੀ ਇਜ਼ ਪ੍ਰੇਜ਼ਿੰਗ ਗੁਰੂ ਰਾਮ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਚਰਨ ਸੋ ਹਾਈਲੀ। ਐਂਡ ਭਾਈ ਲਹਿਣਾ ਜੀ ਇਜ਼ ਹੈਵਿੰਗ ਦ ਲੱਕੀ ਟਾਈਮ ਆਫ ਹੋਲਡਿੰਗ ਇਜ਼ ਗੁਰੂਜ਼ ਚਰਨ ਐਂਡ ਮਸਾਜਿੰਗ ਦਮ ਵਾ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਸਲੀਪਿੰਗ। ਸੋ ਹੀ ਇਜ਼ ਹੈਵਿੰਗ ਦ ਟਾਈਮ ਆਫ ਹਿਜ਼ ਲਾਈਫ। ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਇਜ਼ ਇਨ ਆਨੰਦ ਐਂਡ ਦੇ ਸਲੀਪਿੰਗ। ਐਂਡ ਵਾਟ ਹੈਪਨ ਸਡਨਲੀ ਦੈਟ ਭਾਈ ਲਹਿਣਾ ਜੀ ਹਿਜ਼ ਹੈਂਡਸ ਹੀ ਲੁਕਸ ਡਾਊਨ ਆਰ ਕਵਰਡ ਇਨ ਬਲੱਡ। ਹੀ ਲੁਕਸ ਇਜ਼ ਗੁਰੂਜ਼ ਫੀਟ ਐਂਡ ਇਜ਼ ਫੁੱਲ ਆਫ ਲਿਟਲ ਲਿਟਲ ਹੋਲਸ ਐਂਡ ਇਜ਼ ਬਲੱਡ ਸੀਪਿੰਗ ਆਊਟ ਆਫ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ ਫੀਟ ਐਂਡ ਹੀ ਸ਼ੌਕਡ। His hands are covered in blood and he's thinking, where is this blood coming from? It's coming from Guruji's feet. How is it coming here? Guruji is lying here. A minute ago he was perfectly fine. And now suddenly his feet are covered in blood and my hands are covered in blood. So he asks Maharaj, Maharaj, what is going on to the soul? What's happening to your feet? Maharaj wakes up and they say to Pai Lanaji, obviously our Guru, they rest. They say to Pai Lanaji, before I tell you what's going on, go to a person, a place, they say a place, which is like Ujaad. Ujaad means just wilderness. They go, utthe jao, utthe ek Sikh milega, onu itthe leke aao. So they sent a servant, a Sikh, to go to that place. And they, when they got there, there was a guy who was grazing his goats. He was a goat herd. And they said, bring him over here. When they brought him back, that goat herd was, did matha take to Maharaj. And Maharaj says, Ki Sikha, you were reading Kirtan Sohila Katha. He goes, Hanji Maharaj, I was in Anand. I was reading Kirtan Sohila Katha. Us vele there was only 3 Shabads in Kirtan Sohila. One of those obviously is the Aarti as well. So people used to say Kirat Aarti. It was even called Kirtan Aarti because it was Aarti Shabad was inside it. So the Sikh was reading that with so much love. You know this same Shabad of Aarti we're going to cover at some point, obviously in our Katha. But at one point, a famous poet, Rabindranath Tagore, he said this was the most beautiful Shabad he's ever read in his entire life. That's what he said about Aarti Shabad. Oh, Sikh utthe bada prasan hoke ga reha hai. Mara says, you know what? What happened? Mara says, you were singing part in so much pyar, in so much anand. You started walking, and as you started walking, I started following you. Because wherever the Guru is reading that part, wherever a Sikh is reading that part, then Guru becomes hazir to that Sikh. They are there present, listening to that part. They say, as you were walking, you started walking over some kande, thorns on the ground. They said, because you were in that pyar, I wouldn't let you suffer the pain of those kande, of those thorns. So I took them on myself. But then I started following you and I got more on myself. Dono paase lagge mainu. Ek tere karke, te ek mere karke. And they said, as I was walking, I took all the pain onto you, then my feet started bleeding. Te the Pai Lehna ji, so the blood come on my feet. There's a suksham sarir and a asthul sarir. Suksham means subtle body. Subtle meaning the soul. And there's a asthul sarir, the physical body. And the two have got a link. Sometimes what happens to the asthul sarir will happen to the sukshma sarir. For example, when people get affected by something physical and you get a shock. When someone is doing simran sometimes, then that link between the sukshma sarir and the asthul sarir becomes a bit tenuous. Sometimes they can leave their body. They can detach from their physical body. But then they come back. Because imagine if they got a shock in their sukshma sarir while they were meditating, they would come back into their body as well. And they would shake over there as well. So there's a link, but it can separate. And Maharaj there was taking the pain on their sukshma sarir, but the physical pain was coming on to their asthul sarir. So, what happens next? Pailana ji says, Maharaj, so does this happen every time? Whenever anybody reads Kirtan Sohila, you'll be there. Maharaj says, of course I'll be there. And I will take away the pain and I'll protect my Sikh when they read this part. But Pailana ji was a bit dukhi. They said, Maharaj, nowadays you tell us to read this part in the afternoon. But they said, when they read it in the afternoon, people are doing many, many different things. And you might be taking this pain from everybody. So they say, Maharaj, Bentiya, do something. I don't want to see you like this, bleeding every afternoon. So then, Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, they say, okay. They say, we'll make this part then, the nighttime part, before you go to sleep. Eh raat wala part tad ho gaya sega. Before it was meant in the afternoon, then it got moved to just before you go to sleep, Kirtan Sohila. And always kept the same, those three Shabads. And then when it came to Guru Arjan Dev Ji's time, at that time Maharaj then added two more Shabads. One by Guru Ramdas Ji Maharaj, their own Guru, and one of their own Shabads, the last one. So these two Shabads got added and it became five Shabads. In the same way, jada hon hai gaya in Guru Granth Sahib Ji Maharaj. But before people read this part, some people often read some Shabads called Rakhia De Shabad. Hands up if you've heard of this Shabad. Je nahi sunya, ta theek hai. If you've heard of it, badhiya, okay. Rakhia De Shabad. What are Rakhia De Shabad? Rakhia means protection. Rakhia De Shabad, this was a rivaz, a tradition started in the time of Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj. At that point, there was a Sikh that came to Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj and he did a benti. Guru Sahib is in Harmandir Sahib. Now take yourself forward about 100 years. It's about 1602 to 1604. Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj is involved in writing out the entire Ad Granth Sahib Ji with Pai Gurdas Ji. Every day, they're reciting Bani. Every day, Pai Gurdas Ji is writing his Bani down. Obviously, the Sangha still gets some time to see them. So, the Sangat is coming to Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj. And one Sikh comes one day. And this Sikh, his job is to sell horses. He's a trader. But unfortunately, he suffered a lot in his business because whenever he travels from one town to the other town, when he buys horses from here and sells them there, in between, obviously, they suffer in the travel. He ends up getting robbed. People are following him and robbing him. And wada bahut nuksan ho raha hai. He's losing a lot of money. So he comes to Guru Maharaj and says, Maharaj, do something for me. I'm stuck. He told his whole story. He says, Maharaj, abki getting robbed by these thieves. Please help me, mera kuch karo, taki jere e chor ne na, e mera sab kuch kho na sakan. So Guru Maharaj says, tusi Kirtan Sohila padhya karo. Maharaj says, he still says, ki Guru Sahib, I know you're telling me to do Kirtan Sohila, but please do one more benti that help me with something else for protection on top, that I don't get robbed, that these chores can't touch me. So Guru Sahib said, okay. And they gave him four Shabads. These four Shabads, obviously, is that the ones that we read. And these four Shabads, I'm going to go through as well. But one is Surat Mahalla Panjwa, Gur Ka Shabad Rakhware, Chauki Chaukir Thamare. The next one is Bilawal Mahalla Panjwa Tati Vaun Lagai Paar Brahm Saranai. The next two are from Slok Bhavan Akhri, Slok Mahalla Panjwa, Jaisa Du Gobind Pajan Kirtan Nanak Neet, that one. And then the fourth one is Slok Mahalla Panjwa, which is in Gujri Ki War. And Mara says ki, Man Mein Chitvo Chitvani, Udam Karo Uthneet, Har Kirtan Ka Aharo, Har Dehu Nanak Ke Meet. So these four Shabads. Now the Sikh, Maharaj said to him, eh char shabad tusi na kirtan sona to pehla padhna hai. And then what you're going to do is, after you read the five shabads of Kirtan Sohila that I've given you, the last thing you do is read ardas. So I gave him five hukams. Ki panch shabad ek ardas te char shabad. Char shabad pehla, first before part, read those four rakhya de shabad. And then at the end, you do the whole thing and you do ardas. So now this is what people read. It's 10 things. But then Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj, in the Bavanja Hukam, they say that when you're reading Kirtan Sohila, at the end, add the Salok, Pavan Guru Pani Pita. mata tarat mahat. So what we're going to do is we're going to go through all those shabads, including the slok again at the end. But what happened is that people started to see these shabads and they started to add some sangha samaryada ehogi. They added two more shabads that are very prachalat, especially in the Buddha Dal Gutka, the Nihang Singh Gutka. And why not just do two more shabads as well, because they're both from Guru Granth Sahib Ji anyway, and we can understand them while we're doing the katha. And those two shabads, oh, I'll tell you the story of the Sikh first. Oh, ki hoya, I'll tell you that in a minute. But I'll tell you, there's two more shabads, which are both from Slok Sanskriti. Okay, and we're going to go through them today if we can, if we've got enough time. There's a 52nd slok and the 18th slok in Slok Sanskriti. What's interesting is that this 52nd slok, the 52nd slok in Slok Sanskriti, Sir Mastak Rakhya Par Bhavang, Prad Brahman, Hastakaya Rakha Parameswara. That Shabad in the Freed Kortika, it calls this Shabad Brahm Kavach. Right? Obviously, Brahm Kavach is also a name for a Bani that is normally attributed to Guru Har Gobind Sahib Ji Maharaj and is meant to be read 32 times a day as protection. Kavach means armor. You know, when you got ready for war and you put armor on your arms, on your chest, chatti, pitte, kavach, onu kavach kehnde hai gen, is protection. So it's called Brahm Kavach in the Freed Kortika, this Shabad. So anyway, going back to the story of the guy with the horses. Because you know, sometimes you go ahead. So what happens? Maharaj said to him, tu Kirtan Sohila jarur padhna hai. Now some people question, ki kyon kariye paath? But if we look in our itihas, even Pai Gurdas, he talks about Kirtan Sohila and the maryada of Guru Granth Sahib Ji. And anyway, when someone comes to Guru Granth Sahib Ji Maharaj, it starts with Japji Sahib. Maharaj starts with Japji Sahib. Then they go to Rehra Sahib. Then they get to Kirtan Sohila. So it's obvious to any Sikh, ki eh tin nitname hai gaye, first things first, asi karne hi karne. Paave tusi puri panjbani na karo, but harek Sikh nu kat to kat, eh tin paath karne chahide ne. Sire Japji Sahib, Japji Sahib, Shami Rehra Sahib Te Rati, Kirtan Sohila. Whether you're Amritari or not, every Sikh should at least do these three parts. Morning Japji Sahib, evening Rehra Sahib, Te Rati, before you go to sleep, night time, Kirtan Sohila. Because that's a minimum for any Sikh. Now, in Pai Gurdas Ji Amara, they talk about ki Sanje Sodar Gavana Man Meli Kar Mel Milande. He gives, what do Gur Sikhs do in Kartarpur, he talks about. And he goes, Sanje means Rehras, in the evening time, Sandhya Samay, what do they do? Sanje Sodar Gavana Man Meli Kar Mel Milande. They join together and they meet together and they sing Sodar together. Obviously in the Gurdwara, they do Sodar together. Then he writes, Rati Kirat Sohila Kar Arti Prasad Vadande. He goes, Rati na, night time, they read Kirtan Sohila and also they read Arti inside that, because Arti Shabad is inside it, and Prasad Vadande, then they give out food to each other, Prasad Khandini. So this is a rivaz from the very beginning. From last 500 years, every Sikh who calls himself or herself a Sikh has been reading these Shabads, the ones that we're going to go through. So, ena socho ki bhaiya apna kedi part karege. This is very important for every Sikh to do. So, what happens to this guy now, the horse trader? So, he said, okay, Maharaj, I'm going to go now. Thank you so much for these five Shabads. I'm going to do that. So, he starts traveling. When he starts traveling, he buys two horses. He buys two horses. As he's traveling, he ties them up at night time and he goes to sleep. Before he goes to sleep, he listens to his Guru's bachan. He does Panjishnan. Panjishnan means five parts. So your face, your hands and your feet. Obviously, people used to walk barefooted or wear chappals in those days. Yeah. So they Panjishnan karna. So he does his Panjishnan, focuses upon his Guru, and with very pyar and tyan, he reads out the char shabads, reads out the whole of Kirtan Sohila, and then does ardas, and he goes to sleep. As he goes to sleep, around him, Maharaj's bachan was, when you do this, around you there will be an iron fort. A fortress of iron will get built around you. Now obviously we believe in loha as well. We carry sarab loh. Yeah? Maharaj says, loha di kot tere aale wale ho jaogi. Chogird. So he gets an iron fort around him. The thieves that are waiting to pounce upon his horses, they can't even get inside. So they're stuck outside the whole night. They were following him. They're waiting for him to fall asleep. They can't get in. The next day, he does the same thing. Third day, he does the same thing. So it's going like this and thieves are getting very frustrated. They can't get in. But one night, that Sikh is traveling and he gets very tired. And you know how it is when you get very tired. You think, I'll just lie down for a second. Right? I'll just rest my eyes for a second and I'll get up in a minute and do my part. As he rests his eyes, he falls asleep. As he falls asleep, the thieves are waiting for this very moment. They come in into his place where he's resting. They undo the horses. They put the saddles on the horses because they're going to get on them and ride away. They do everything. As they're about to walk away, the Sikh wakes up when he's doing his part. As he wakes up, he goes, oh, but it is ho gaya. I just fell asleep like this. So he quickly washes his hands and feet, washes his face, sits down and does Rakhia de Shabad, Kirtan Sohila and Ardas. Now what happens? As he does this, the iron fortress gets again around him. But the thieves now are trapped inside. They're not outside trying to get in, they're trapped inside trying to get out. And they can't. Yeah? They're trapped inside, they can't leave. Now, these the chores, the thieves, they get very interested in this. They think, you know what? This guy has got some real powers. We won't let us in. Whenever he reads a certain mantra, certain mantan, then this fortress goes up. They go, you know what we should do? Forget the horses. We should get this mantra off him. It's very powerful, this mantra. Whatever it is, it's very powerful. So in the morning, when the Sikh wakes up, and what does Guru Sahib tell him? They say to him that you're going to be protected until the morning when you do Ishnan and you read Japji Sahib. Then that fortress will open and you can go outside as well. So they're protecting him all night until he wakes up in the morning, has a shower, has a bath and reads his Japji Sahib part. So this Sikh wakes up, he does Ishnan, does Japji Sahib part, he reads, and he goes over to where the horses are. And there's these thieves sitting there as well. And he goes, what are you doing here? Who are you? They go, actually, we're the thieves. We've been robbing you for a long time. They go, even if you put us in prison now, even if you call the police, you get us in prison, that's fine. But do one thing. Tell us this thing that you read. What do you read to get this fortress around you? And what do you read to get rid of it? What are these magical formulas? And the Sikh says, bhai, this is Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj's bakshish. What I can do is take you to Guru Maharaj. So the Sikh now takes these thieves to Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj in Amritsar, and their Guru Maharaj blesses them that they stop becoming thieves, they become into good people, and unadi bhi udhar ho janda hai. So the Shabad, obviously when Guru Sahib gives us anything, it's not just for that Sikh, it's for everybody. So from that time, the Sikhs all started to read these Panj Shabads, obviously Ardas included. So what we're going to try and do is maybe at the end of this, maybe do Aarti the Katha and then go through Ardas as well. Because that would be good to do a bit of history. Yeah. So then what happens is that the Sikh, obviously this Rehat becomes part of Maryada, and most Sikhs now do read Rakhya De Shabad when they go to sleep. If you don't know what they are, if you don't know about the Rakhia de Shabad, you can find them by going onto any Gutka, especially the apps. If you go into Taksal, Damdami Taksal Sundar Gutka app, it's the black one with the Khanda. If you get that one, then inside there you can get the Gutka of both the Damdami Taksal and the Buddha Dal. Now obviously the two Shabads I'm going to go through now, they're only in the Buddha Dal Gutka. Okay? But you can get that, obviously they're from Slok Sanskriti anyway. By Guru Neji Pasha. So now what is it? Obviously we're reading it today, but none of us are trading in horses. Yeah, we're quite safe in our houses, we got alarms and everything else, yeah? So we might think, Padandi Lodini. We might think there's no need for us to read these Shabads now. But actually, if you look through Gurbani Par Darpan by Sant Gurbachan Singh Khalsa Pindrawale of Damdami Taksal, if he goes through it, what they say is those thieves that the Sikh was worried about were the horse thieves. But they said that every Sikh has also got Panj, Chor, these five thieves that can attack you at night time. And at night time they can steal all your kamai. Because obviously every Sikh during the day is trying to earn money. Even the Shabads in Kirtan Sohila talk about the fact that you have to earn this hartan, this wealth of naam. Jako aaye sohi bihajo. Maharaj says you've come for to trade in this naam, so start to trade in this naam. So you're earning the wealth of naam during the day. At night time, if you read this part, then the kaam, krodh, lobh, moh, ahankar, especially the kaam and krodh, they can't steal all your money. Because Sasangaji, you know at night time when we go to sleep, that is when kaam affects us most. If you look at Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj, they're only 9 years old. Their father, Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji Maharaj, is saying to Guru Gobind Singh Ji when they're 9 years old, because nahun sudha gi unanu, they've realized what life, what married life is going to be about. They understand that men and women get married and then they have kids. So they understand the whole process, just what they go through in school as well. Your kids of that age get told about these things in school. So they've got the sudha now of how life works. And then Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji Maharaj, in Guru Gobind Singh Ji writes this down themselves in Chirtopakhyan Granth. They write down what Guru Gobind Singh Ji was told by Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji when they were 9 years old. And Maharaj writes, Sud jab te ham tari bachan gur de hamare. Jab mainu sud aagi na, then my bachan, my guru gave me this bachan. Bachan means a hukam. What was his hukam? Put tohe pran eh pran jab lag ghat tare. Put, he say, put, oh my son, from now on eh pran tohe. Make sure you promise me this now. Enu pran kalo. Pran means to make it strong in your heart, to make a strong commitment. Ehe pran tohe, pran jab lag kat tare. Until your breath is in your body, make this thing solid in your heart for the rest of your life, they say. What is this thing that they say? They say, nij nari ke sang neh tum nit badaiyo, par nari ke sej pul supne ho na jaiyo. They say, you know, your nijnari, your own personal woman, your wife. They say, with that woman who is your wife, parnari nijnari ke sang, with her, nehetum nitabadayo. You can, every day, you can grow your love with her. Whether you want to take that in a married life way, obviously it's meant in that way because it's meant for those people that are married. They're saying, you can, every day, you can grow your love with them. But they say, parnari ke sej, the bed of somebody who is not your wife, par nari ke sej, pool supne hona jayyo. They go, not even in your, by pool ke na, by forgetting, even in your dreams, don't go to her bed. Sasani socho, how high must our thinking and our sochni have to be that even in our dreams we don't go there? Most people will say, hoi ni sakda. Most people nowadays, if you say this to the people outside, they'll say, it can't happen, mate. They say, even in your dreams, you can't stop your mind wandering. But Guru Gobind Singh is being told by their father, even in your dreams, don't let your mind wander off to somebody else's bed. How can we do this? If we keep our mind focused upon Gurbani during the day, and at night time when we go to sleep, again, we read Kirtan Swarada part, ki jire kaam krodh ne na, kaam and krodh are our biggest thieves, that they stay away from us at night time, and we don't lose our kamai. Our mind stays in our control inside that lohe da kar, that kotadi of loha. It comes all around you and it will protect your mind from wandering off into the wrong place. So, bahut zaruri hai ga har ek sikh vaste ki raati son to pehla o kirtan sohila da paath kare te us to pehla rakhia de shabad vi padhe. Very important. So, we'll go through now the very first shabad. Now, this comes up in slok sanskriti and Mara says, and it's obviously there's slok sanskriti of Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, and following that there's slok sanskriti of Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj. Now what's interesting about slok sanskriti, I'm not going to go through it in too much detail, but the way it's written, it sounds a little bit like a pandit's mantra. Although it's written in Gurbani, it sounds like very much like what you might hear from the pandits of India when they read their mantras. Yeah? Why is Maharaj writing in that way? Many people have given their thoughts, and people have obviously people more advanced. But one of the reasons is because people thought Guru Sahib couldn't write that way. And Guru Sahib is almost kind of like writing that way, but still giving Gurbani Gyan, using words that are in Gurbani. So it sounds like it, but it's not that. So normally this is called Menge Shabad. Why is it Menge Shabad? Because We don't say Gurbani is hard or Gurbani is okhi. That would make no sense. Gurbani is saying okhi kadi na dekhan dein. Maharaj is saying, let me not see any awkward times. But how can we then say the Bani is okhi to read? Because the Bani is here to give you only sukh. So what we say is a menge shabad ne. Menge means they're expensive, means you have to spend some time earning how to pronounce them so that we don't make mistakes. Obviously, I am going to end up making mistakes, but I'm going to try and go through them. But Maharaj says, Sir Mastak, Rakhia Par Brahmanang. Mastak means our matha, and Sir means our head. So Sir Mastak, and here the tatta is on the pair, pari tatta. Obviously, it's very rare to see a pari tatta. Yeah? So even some fonts in Gurmukhi don't even have the option. You can't even write it because it's so rare. But it is possible to have a pari tatta. You might have seen a pari vava, very common to prasad svaye. You might have seen a pari yaya or a pari haha. But here, it's a pari tatta. So Mara says, Sir mastak rakhya par brahmanam hastakaya rakhya parameswarah. Mara says, Par Brahmanang, Vaheguru, the supreme, ek hai ga Brahm, ek hai ga Par Brahm. Brahma is the one that made this world. Par Brahm is the one that made everything, not just what he made in this specific world. So Par Brahm, the supreme Vaheguru, has protected my Sir and my Mastak. One way to see the word Mastak is to mean our destiny as well. Because Gurbani will say that on your matha is written your destiny. So, Sir Mastak Rakhya, and Te Khakhe Thale Pairi Yayaya. So, Rakhya, it's not Rakha, but Rakhya. You have to pronounce the Yayaya. Sir Mastak Rakhya Par Brahmanang Hast Kaya Rakhya Parameswarah. So, here, Parameswarah, again the same similar kind of word, Maharaj says that Vaheguru has protected my hands and my body. Hast means hand and kaya means your body. Maharaj carries on, they go, Atam rakhya Gopal Swami, Tan Charan rakhya Jagdishwarah. Maharaj says, Gopal Swami, that Vaheguru who is looking after the world, that Vaheguru who is the one who is Paldaya, is Dunyanu Gopal Swami, the Lord Master, Atam rakhya. Atam here does not mean your soul. It means your mind. Like we say in Bani, Ki jako har rang lago is jugme, so kahiyat hai sura, atam jine, sagal vasta ke jaka satgur pura. Atam doesn't mean your soul, atam means your mind here. So our mind is protected by Gopal Swami Vaheguru, and then tan charan rakhya jagdivis jagdishwarah. Charan here means your feet, and your tan means your wealth. So it's talking about the whole body. So when we say every part of our body, it's why it's called like a kavach. Because you're kind of like, you know when you get ready for war, imagine somebody's getting ready for war, yeah? And he's putting on his shastar kadi. After he's put everything on, then he looks around and says, right, got to protect my feet here, got to protect my waist here, got to protect my arms, got to protect my shoulders, my chest. So in this way, this Shabad is a bit like, you're naming every part of your body, and you're saying, Maharaj, edhi bhi rakha kar lo, edi bhi rakhya kar lo, and here mada ni sikh e bhi keh raha maharaj mere tannu bhi bacha lo, save my money as well. Because that first sikh, when he started in his ardas, he was saying maharaj mere kode chori jande hege, so onnu bhi bacha lo. It's not wrong for us to say maharaj save me from getting robbed in the actual physical chor tarike. So then sarab rakhya gurdayal hai pai dukh binasan hai. Sarab rakhya gur Dayalah. Everything is protected by Guru who is Dayal, merciful. Guru Dayalah. Yeah. Pai dukh binasana. He can take away our pai, our fear, our dukh, which is our pains, and binasana. Binasana means to destroy. When we say avinasi, that means can't be destroyed. So binas means to destroy. Binasana. And then Maharaj says, Pagat Vachal Anathanathe Saran Nanak Purak Achutah. Pagat Vachal. Vachal means the love. And obviously the Pagats are those that are doing Pagti of Vaheguru. So he's Pagat Vachal. He loves his Pagats. Now it might seem strange, But we think God should love everybody. Normally, aam banda kehnda hai, God loves everybody. But Gurbani is saying ki santan dukh paaye te dukhi, sukh paaye sadhun ke sukhi. Maharaj Guru Gobind Singh Ji is saying that when the people who worship Him become happy, Waheguru becomes even happier. So He takes joy in our joy. Those that come close to Him, those that worship Him, Maharaj looks after them even more. Don't think that He's not, He obviously is giving to everybody, but those that turn towards Him, they're like, okay, like for example, a parent will give to all of their children, right? Whether you're good or bad, you know your mom's going to give you breakfast and lunch and dinner. Very rare they'll take that away from you. But if you're angry, they'll still call you down, khale. So they still look after you. In the same way, Waheguru will still give you, but if you become that good child, then on top of that food, the bare minimum, you get all that love from Waheguru as well, which is going to be inside your heart as well. So apa change hi bach banna ya. We don't want to be mare bachche of Waheguru, we want to be good bachche of Waheguru. Change bachche banna. So Maharaj says here, ki pagat bachchal anath nathe. He is the Nath, the Lord, the Father, the Nath of the Anathe. Those that have got no one in this world, then Waheguru is their someone. Pagat vachal anath nathe sar nanak purukh achut hai. Achut means to be untouchable. Untouchable as in pure and obviously unreachable in that sense, because nothing can make him dirty. So Nanak has come to the sharan of that person who is achut, who's always going to remain pure and separate from this world as well. So that's the first one, the first look. And then, obviously for us, if we say these Shabads, then Maharaj Kripa Kare, we coming to their Sharan, they will protect us as well. Then Maharaj, in the Slok 18 of Sanskriti, then this Shabad comes up. Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj, they say, Kor Dukhyang Anak Hatyang Janam Dardang Mahabhikhadyang Mitant Sagal Simrant Harnam Nanak Jaise Pav Kast Pasmanang Krot. So you see, it sounds very different from normal Gurbani. Huh? What is that Shabad mean? Maharaj says, Kor Dukhyang. Ethe Khakke Thale Yaya, Adda Yaya. So you have to pronounce it Dukhyang. Kor means very deep, very dark, very intense. Intense amount of Dukh. Imagine you're in an intense amount of dukkha right now. It can happen to any one of us. Normally, life is not like this. Normally, life is like this. Ups and downs. Someday you're really happy. And you're thinking, oh, I could just live like this forever. Then, 2 weeks later, things have gone so down. You're like, why is my life so terrible? Some people, 2 weeks later, want to end their life. Two weeks earlier, they couldn't wait to live this life as the way they were living. Things can go up and down so much. This is the life without Sahaj. It's Sabde Vichya. Those that are not in Sahaj, the fourth avastha of Sahaj, all of them are up and down. So we're all in Dukh and outside Dukh. Maharaj is telling us to reach a state through Sikhi where you can be outside of Dukh. Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji Maharaj obviously reached that stage. But the six around them, they reach that stage as well. That's why Guru Maharaj says, Jo nar dukh mein dukh nahi mane, sukh saneho, ar pay nahi jaake, kanchan mati mane. Imagine that situation. What do they say? They say in that situation, they say, asa mansa sagal tyage, jagte rahe nirasa. Kaam krodh jeh parse nahi, tai jan tai kate brahm nivasa. They go, imagine that person who's in this world has got no desire. Asa, mansa, sagal tyage. Leaves all their desires and of their heart, of the desires for this world. Jagte rahe nirasa. They live in this world, but they're like, I don't care. Today I get hit by a bus. It doesn't affect me. Tomorrow I lose my house. Everything doesn't affect me. All they want is Waheguru. Maharaj says, but most of us are in dukkh. Most of us are in dukkh and sukh. We go through these two kapde. Just like you take one off, you put the next one on, and you take that one off, and you go back to sukh. So ite benti, if you're going through dukkh right now, understand that this is one more kapra you're going to take off one day. If you're going through a lot of pain right now in your life, It could be happening to anybody right now. Just understand that this kapda of dukh you will take off one day and you will put on the kapda of sukh. This is the way the world works. So don't get too dukhi that you finish your life. Don't get too dukhi that you think it's never going to change. It will change. It will, because this is the way the world works. Maharaj says, but kor dukhyang. If you're in so much dukh, anik hatyang. Hatyang means murder. Anik means so many. Beyant. They say, imagine you're somebody who is in so much dukh. Imagine you're somebody who's done so much sin that is equivalent to you have killed so many people. Socho jara. If we met somebody who had actually killed so many people, we would think it's not possible for them to be forgiven. Hana? That's what we would say normally. It's not possible. Inu kaun maaf karuga? Maharaj says, anik hatyang. So many murders. Janam dardang. What does dardang mean? It means to be poor. Very, very poor. Yeah? Kangal kendo. Grieb. Your whole life is poor. You're born into poverty and you live your life in poverty and you die in poverty. That's janam daridram. You're completely as a beggar. Now here you could say, without naam as well, you never had any naam. Maharaj says, maha bikhadyang. Bikhadyang means misery, ultimate misery. A life full of misery, or you could say a life full of kalesh. Some people, they have a house, they have food, they have family, but they have so much bikhadyang, misery. Why? Because in the house, there is kalesh. Satsang ji, ek kar kalesh da kar hai ga, te ek kar shanti da kar. One is like hell, and one is like heaven. Ehi honda na? When you got kalesh in your house, it doesn't matter whether you've got a roof and you've got four walls and a bed. It doesn't matter because you're completely in dukh. Maharaj says, maha bikhadyam. Not just a little bit, but a lot of misery. Maha bikhadyam. So imagine if we put ourselves in a position, the worst we could ever get in our life is to be in this situation. We've got so much dukh. We've committed so much sins. We've got so much poverty in our life. We're completely poor, empty. And we're in complete misery. There's kalesh all around us. Full of fighting, full of sins. Maharaj says then, mitant sagal simranta har naam nanak. Mitant means wiped out. Mitant sagal. All of those can be wiped out. Simrant har naam nanak. Oh, why Guru Nanak is saying, Muranda is saying that all of these can be wiped out by just saying Waheguru's name. Simrant. Not just saying it, but with your whole body remembering Waheguru. Remembering the one who created you. Going back and remembering that person. Maharaj says, Mitant sagal simrant har naam. By remembering the name of that one who made you. Nanak, jaise pavak kasht pasamang karot. What does that mean? Jaise means just like. Jaise pavak. Pavak means fire. Cast means wood. Like fire to a piece of wood. Maharaj says pasmang. Pasmanang. Pasmanang. What does that mean? It means to become into dust. And krot means to karna. To do it. How fire can take a piece of wood and turn it into dust. Into complete ashes. Maharaj says Waheguru's name can take away all that dukh, all that sadness, all that paap, all that poverty, spiritual poverty. Everything can be taken out with just Waheguru's name. So the ultimate medicine in this world, that's why Guru Sahib says, Sarab rog ka aukhad naam. Of all the diseases in this world, the solution comes down to naam. Saying Waheguru's name. Akho Waheguru. Waheguru, 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 Waheguru. So bota sama nahi hai ga satsang ji, main hun samapti te aava. In Amir Pandar Sikh, when the Sikhs heard this Shabad by Guru Arjan Ji Pasha in Slok Saiskriti, they asked Guru Maharaj, Is it possible that Vaheguru's name is that powerful? ਇੰਜ ਕੋਈ ਚੀਜ਼ ਹੋ ਸਕਦੀ ਹੈ ਜਿਹਦੇ 'ਚ ਇੰਨੀ ਸ਼ਕਤੀ ਹੋਵੇ ਕਿ ਬਸ ਇੱਕ ਵਾਰੀ ਨਾਲ ਸਭ ਕੁਛ ਨੂੰ ਸਾਫ ਸਭ ਕੁਛ ਨੂੰ ਮਿਟਾ ਸਕਦੀ ਹੈਗੀ ਹੈ ਮਿਟੰਤ ਸਗਲ ਸਿਮਰੰਤ ਹਰ ਨਾਮ ਇਜ ਇਟ ਪੋਸੀਬਲ ਦੈਨ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਗੇਵ ਦਾ ਉੱਤਰ ਉੱਤਰ ਕੀ ਆਇਆ ਦੈ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂਜ਼ ਨੇਮ ਇਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਪਾਵਰਫੁਲ ਇਟ ਇਜ਼ ਅਤ ਰਥੀ ਅਤ ਮੀਨਸ ਅਲਟੀਮੇਟ ਰਥੀ ਮੀਨਸ ਅ ਵਾਰੀਅਰ ਦੇਰ ਇਜ਼ ਥਰੀ ਟਾਈਪਸ ਆਫ ਰਥੀ ਵਨ ਇਜ਼ ਵਟ ਯੂ ਮਾਈਟ ਕਾਲ ਅ ਰਥੀ Rathi is someone that can fight one-on-one with somebody. Then you've got a Maharathi that 10,000 people can come against and that one person can fight against 10,000. Like when you see in Chandi Diwar, then Durga seems to fight against so many people. So she's like Maharathi. But Maharaj says that Vaheguru's name is Atarathi. It can fight against unlimited amount of enemies. There is no limit to Vaheguru's name's power. That's what they're saying here. It's Atarathi. And Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj tells us that in Chope Sahib, when they say, Ek baar jin to main sambhara, kaal phaas te tahin ubara, jin nar naam tiharo kaha, darid dusht dokh te raha. Darid here is the same word as in poverty. And dusht means enemies. Maharaj says, Vaheguru's name can actually save you in this way. So obviously, it is that powerful. And even Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj says that in Raag Kanada, on Ang 3000, 1300, Guru Arjan Dev Ji Maharaj says, they say, Simrant ek baar har har mit kot kasmal jatang. Simrat ek baar har har. Once, if you say Vaheguru's name, once. They say, if you do that, mit kot kasmal jatang. Millions of sins get wiped out by saying Vaheguru's name even once. So, Bentiya, when you wake up in the morning, make sure you do a little bit of simran. You don't know. That day, you might were going to get hit by a bus, and then you just get scared by a bus. You don't know how Guru Sahib can protect you. You don't know that day you're going to lose your business, and you just lose a tenner. You know, it's like you're walking through life, and you've got a protection all around you. Things are happening around you, but somehow they can't get through to you, because you've got this fort of iron around you. When you read Kirtan Sohila, when you wake up in the morning, read Japji Sahib, then throughout that day, the Guru Shabad is protecting you. Don't think, Mainu ki milia. Eh socho, Mainu ki nahi milia. What were the things you were gonna get that you didn't get because Guru Sahib was protecting you? We can't see those things. A child doesn't know when the father is letting it walk. The child thinks, I'm walking by myself. When you're holding their feet, you're putting their feet on your feet, you got their hands, and you're walking them around, and they think, wow. I started to learn to walk. But actually, the parent is holding that child. And the child is walking and the parent could be blocking so many things. They could be stopping them from falling. The child doesn't know. The child does not realize. So Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj, all our gurus are like that father to us that will protect us when walking through this world. And so much dukh won't even touch us. Rogante, arsogante, jaljogante, bahupath bachave. Shatra anek chalavat kao, tau tan ek na lagan paave. Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj writes that you protect me from so many things. Hundreds of enemies are throwing bullets and arrows upon me, but not even one can touch my body. You imagine somebody running through a field of arrows being shot at them and they come out and they're like, I didn't get hit. That's how Vaheguru is towards us. If we start to use Bani as our protection, not if we do nothing, but if we use these shabas to protect us. So Bentiya, if you haven't read Rakhia the Shabad before, you just do Kirtan Sohila, go home, get the app and start to read these shabas as well. Agle hafte we're going to go through the actual four Rakhia the Shabad, but you can go through these as well. Inya Bentiya parwan kaniya, pulan chukan di khema, gaj gaj ke fateh akho, Wahe Guru Ji ka khalsa, Wahe Guru Ji ki fateh.
If you enjoyed this video, please like, comment, share and subscribe. Please donate and help spread Guruji's message. Link is in the description below. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.